What's up, everyone? It's your boy, Terry, speaking from the garage shop again. It offers you some more big bang for the buck product and info. Yeah. Well, I'm sitting up here, you know, getting all the parts ready for the 67 Chevelle because we're going to be starting on that soon, and you don't want to miss it because we're going to build the whole car up, and it's going to be a cool build. But we can't. Hold on a second. Can't do it. Not talking about that today. No, what we're talking about is performing a mod that will drastically, dramatically change the performance of the Trailblazer SS, give me ability over the compression and rebound, and also the height of the car, the way it sits.
If you think about it, you know what I'm talking about.
But if you don't, let's go to where I keep my parts so I can make it nice and clear. Now, you guys, y'all know the drill. I'm not going to have to tell you that, you know, you should, you know, subscribe, because I don't have to tell you that there's a lot of videos coming down. And, you know, I want you guys to be a part of it. You know, I don't have to mention that. I also don't have to mention that you should also hit that bell so you can get notified whenever a video comes out, because, again, I'm not going to tell you that you don't want to miss any of these videos, because I got a whole lot of videos coming down that, you know, going to be pretty hype, and I want you guys to watch it. So I don't have to tell you that, and I'm not going to. Bell. But yes, you guys are very clever. You knew I was talking about coilovers. I'm talking about coilovers for the Trailblazer SS. Now, coilovers are a huge part of the automotive performance industry since they first came out. You have a choice between a double or a single adjustable. You can adjust the compression and the rebound of the shock, and most importantly, you can set the ride height of the vehicle. I don't see any disadvantages. I see all benefits. So it was just a matter of time for Trailblazer vehicle and Trailblazer-like vehicle owners to say, well, why can't we get that coilover technology for our Trailblazer and Trailblazer SS-like SUV vehicles? Huh? Well, your prayers have been answered, because Beltec and KW got together and they made a coilover system designed specifically for the Trailblazer and Trailblazer-like SUV vehicle. Now, you can pick this kit up from Summit, and it comes in the traditional purple and yellow, and I'm gonna show you how easy it is to put this together. Comes with the shock. I usually like to bottom this out. All right, now remember, whenever you do coilovers, this is aluminum, and this is also aluminum. So to prevent galling, what you wanna do is you wanna make sure you use a lot of anti-seize, so it might get a little sloppy, but even still, it's a lot better than trying to free up a galled up piece of aluminum. Take it from here, the spring. Spring, I like to put it upside right. All right. Sits right on top. Now, whenever you're doing coilovers or struts, you should always, always get a new mount. The mount will come like this. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna have to finagle. You know, sometimes these things are hard to take off, but just pry right off. Never again. After, you're gonna have two washers. You're gonna have one that's like this and one that's bigger. This is the bigger one. The bigger one goes on the bottom, like so. But first, what we gotta do, we gotta put the washer, the bottom like that, and then put this over the top of it. Remember this piece right here with the washer inside? Goes in like that. Top, finishes off like that. Fat nut. As you can see, once you put the nut in, it's starting to bottom this hat off, hat down. Let's lock that down. As you can see, it's all together, and we're getting ready to install the unit. But before we do, on these threads, use a little anti-seize, because that will prevent it from sticking 3 or 4 months down the road. Because what will happen is, if you don't use anti-seize, you will have a Jonah of a time trying to move that spanner nut. So just take that equation out, because I put anti-seize on just about everything, because failing to prepare is preparing to fail. Use anti-seize. You can get it from Summit. Now, before you install, I want to set the compression and the rebound. Now, the compression is basically when you hit a bump from where the car is sitting to the point where it dips down. And the rebound would be from where the car is dipping down to the point where it gets back to the normal ride height. So with a double adjustable, you have an adjustment for the rebound, an adjustment for the compression. With a single adjustable, one knob sets both. So I'm gonna start off at a 9 on the compression. So I don't know if you can hear it, you hear clicks. So this is the compression and it goes clockwise. So that's 1, that's 2, 8, 9. On the rebound, I think I'm gonna start with 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now I'm set and I'm ready to install this, and I'll adjust the ride height once this is in. But I gotta take the old strut out because it has a piece that I have to install on here. So I'm able to, a bracket should I say, so I'm able to install it in the truck. So let's uninstall and put this thing in. First thing we gotta do is jack the car up and remove the tire. Don't mess around. You see how I got my jack? I have a stand here. I don't know if you can see it, but there is a stand supporting the car along with the jack. Don't mess around, you know. Safety is number one thing. What I really should do for extra safety, I should throw a tire up in here. Do whatever you have to do to make sure your vehicle stays where you want to stay until you want it to come down, all right? We're gonna loosen these two bolts, as you can see it, one there and one right there. I like loosening them to the point where you can just, they're not off, but they got a couple of threads just in case something jumps off. Yeah, they won't completely come out until you're ready for them to come out. I gotta remove that bolt. See what I mean? I should have used anti-seize. Almost forgot. Turn around, bright eyes. Came out. There we go. Now you can remove those two bolts from the top, and this thing will drop. Let's have a little fun. Tell me what famous hip hop group said the phrase drop. Let me know. All right, now this is the strut that we're replacing. See, this is just a regular coil setup. This bracket right here, this piece, has to come out and be installed on the coilover shock and then put back in. Let's get to going. Oh, you best believe there will be some anti-seize installed on these bad boys. So as you can see, to remove this bracket off of the old shock, it wasn't a Jonah, it was like a junior Jonah of a time. But if you notice, when I removed this bolt, it just slid right out, right? Because I had the anti-seize on it. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm not gonna even mess around. Let's throw a little anti-seize because it's gotta go back on right all up in here, yeah. But a little anti-seize, because when I installed this, the shocks before, I didn't think I was going to be taking them out, but you never know. So remember that whole preparing to fail and failing to prepare? Let's not fail to prepare. Let's prepare, you know, or let's just prepare, or let's not prepare to fail. Let's prepare not to fail. Let's not prepare to fail. You understand what I'm saying? Use anti-seize. Oh, hold on a sec. Almost forgot. Yeah, I know what you guys are thinking. You're thinking, yeah, Ty, what about that piece that you had to bang off? Yeah, I know what you guys are thinking. I'm way ahead of you guys. We're on the same page, you know, exactly. Yeah, I see you. All right. So now I can install this on the coilover, and it goes in just like this. Now, this bolt, once it's in, and we're going to put some more anti-seize on this. Don't worry about it. Not only does it grip around the base here, it's also the bolt's going to slide right in there where it's locked in. Ugh. Not a Jonah. Little persuasion. You know what's up. Yeah. And it's in. Now, I'm not going to tighten this bolt up yet because it allows me maneuverability. You see what I'm saying? So when I put it back in, if it needs to move a little bit or whatever, so it'll find its own place. So now this is pretty much all, you know, like how all coils work. This is going to connect to the bottom of the control arm, and it's going to connect to the top of the car. Now, you notice this little spanner nut right here? As you turn this spanner nut, it's going to raise this, which in essence raises the car. Or if you turn the opposite way, it's going to lower this, which lowers the car. So it's not just a one-shot deal. You're going to have to drive the car, you know, like see where you like it, you know, as far as like if you like the compression or if you like the rebound, you know, drive the car, you know, I say keep one of those keys with you at all times because that key is the same key that once you figure out the height, you see that little right there? You turn that and that will lock the spanner nut in place. So again, you're going to have to drive around, you know, like test it out. See if you like it. If you don't, change it around. Just pretty much dial the car into pretty much your liking. And that's the beauty of a coilover. Let's install. All right. That's fine. And that's two. After it's all said and done, you've now converted your Trailblazer or Trailblazer-like SUV-like vehicles to a coilover setup. See, now the fun really begins because I'm going to put the tire on, I'm going to put the car down, and that's when the adjustments come to play that we talked about earlier. So I'm going to set the rebound, the compression, the ride height, which takes a little time. Like I said, you gotta kind of, you know, roll with it for a couple of days so the shocks will sit in, and then go back, raise it, lower it, change the drive around with it until you dial it into where it's comfortable for you. All right, but I'm looking at the clock on the wall. Or should I say ceiling. Time for me to head on off and do some more videos. Yo, that's what's up. That's what we do. We enjoy them. And I want to say thank you guys for the caring, sharing, and all the love that's been, you know, given to me. And I really, really appreciate that. And we got a lot more videos on the way. You don't want to miss it. There's some special videos coming down. And like I said, there's no me without you. So I want to give you guys a big thanks, and I really appreciate it. But as always, be easy. Damn, it's anti-seize all over the place. And I'll catch you guys real soon. Take care.